We are less than 2 weeks away from SEC Football Media Days, and we're talking Tennessee football with Mike LaValle from Last Word on College Football. Vol's Breakdown comes your way on Mark Rogers TV and SEC Breakdown each and every week. Check out the audio version on Podbean and iTunes. Just search Mark Rogers TV. All right, Mike, we're going to make you do yeoman's work tonight. We're going to run through the Tennessee offense. I know you're up to the challenge, so get ready to talk because you're going to fill us in and up the knowledge base for the rest of us on the Vols offense, because a lot of moving parts, a lot of changes starting at the top at the quarterback position with Josh Dobbs, a lot of new coaches to get familiar with. So why don't we start with that theme, because those are the guys that put the right players in place and make up the scheme and set the tone and the direction. So talk and take us through the coaching changes that have taken place in the offseason there in Knoxville.
Mark, a lot of change on the offensive staff. Only one guy is returning to his position he was at last year, Robert Gillespie. The running back coach is still there, the running back coach, having some great success on the recruiting trail. But the changes start at the top. Larry Scott named the offensive coordinator. Larry Scott was the interim head coach at Miami a couple years ago before the Mark Richt hire. A great offensive mind. It looks like word came out this week that the offense, the Vols offense, might go under center a little bit more. That's been a big consternation with some of the fan base over the past couple years. While the offense has been highly productive, they've struggled at times on those third and shorts, third and one, third and two, third and three, and goal line situations. A lot of fans wanted to see the Tennessee offense go under center, particularly when you had a guy like Jalen Hurd, who you thought could get that 1 or 2 yards. When you run it out of that read option snap, the running back starts 4 yards behind the line of scrimmage. So Larry Scott, some of the reports coming out of Knoxville this week was that Larry Scott will go under center, will have a little bit more leeway as he runs the offense. A lot of the fans are very excited about Larry Scott. Tremendous resume. He was a tight ends coach last year, elevated to offensive coordinator this season. Of course, the Vols offense coming off of some record-setting numbers last season, so he'll have a high bar to measure against, and he's losing a lot of talent. So a lot of people are excited to see what Larry Scott brings to the table as the new offensive coordinator. Walt Wells is the offensive line, returning a lot of experience, a lot of starts. He just has to put those guys together. Also doing well on the recruiting trail as well. Walt Wells there at offensive line. And then Kevin Beard at wide receiver. Probably the biggest question mark, wide receivers, quarterbacks, probably the biggest question marks of the two of the position groups, so the wide receivers and the quarterbacks. Kevin Beard's reunited with Larry Scott, who he coached with at Miami under Larry Coker. And then Mike Canales is the first proper quarterbacks coach that Tennessee's had in several years. They've had a graduate assistant doing the quarterback coaching for the last couple of years. Did a pretty good job. Obviously, the development of Joshua Dobbs was evident from his year to his senior year. Mike Canales comes in with a wealth of quarterbacking coaching experience. Not the resume or the success that you'd like to see, but set on Mike Canales does. Got two young guys there and a couple of commits coming in. A lot of talent. Now let's see if Canales can coach up that talent to produce. A lot of people are going to be looking. Of all the nukes, it's going to be the one that's under the microscope the most, particularly with the fan base. That was the hire over the summer, or over the winter, that resonated least with the fan base.